Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Little Book Exhibition Opening Ceremony 2021. I'm Madam Kaur, your host for today. Over these past few months, the Mother Tongue Department has been actively promoting our reading program. All of you were encouraged and guided by your Mother Tongue teachers to complete Little Books. We are truly heartened to see your active participation and amazing creativity. And that is why we're here today to witness and celebrate the fruit of your labor. We are pleased and honored to invite our school leaders, our school principal, Mrs. Loke, our vice principal, Ms. Medana, and our guest, Mr. Wesley Chong. May I invite Mrs. Loke to give an opening speech? Mrs. Loke, please.
So good morning, teachers and students. We are just so blown away by the amazing creativity of your little books. I came in earlier to take a look at your creative work and understand that some of your stories were written by yourselves. Some of these are your favorite stories and you have written a twist to them. And some of these are summaries of your favorite storybooks. And you have illustrated them. And I love your wonderful artwork. And this is a very creative way to promote the love of reading to one another. So I just want to commend our students for your spirit of excellence, demonstrating our school values. And also the Mother Tongue Department for your innovation and your collaboration. So you have demonstrated many of our school values. I'm just so proud of all of you here. So thank you very much for your hard work, and we look forward to all of us promoting this culture of reading. Thank you very much.
May I once again invite the school leaders to cut the ribbon now. Now, let's invite our reading ambassador, Ang Jia Sheng from For Integrity, to showcase the treasure chest to everyone.
It is a very unique box as you can open like this to start the story. Please, try it.
Wow.
Let's see. So this is the title of the story.
Yes.
Can you tell me what this is?
This is the book. It's a catch.
Oh, it's my book.
I see. And then the next bit.
Oh, yeah. Oh wow!
Oh. And so what happened at the end? Wow, how long did your friend take to make this? Quite a lot of effort, right? Wow, thank you very much.
Our reading ambassadors are going to present their little books written in their respective languages, which is followed by the live demonstration of the Chinese of how to access the Chinese and Tamil e-books. But before we begin, allow me to introduce our reading ambassadors. They are Si Zhu Xu from For Collaboration, Aisha Shahira from 3 Collaboration, Nirvana from 3 Innovation, and Jia Sheng from 4 Integrity. Over to you, reading ambassadors.
Good morning, Mrs. Low, Mrs. Lim, Ms. Santana, and teachers. I'm Cargo of 4CN. Today, I'd like to share about my little book with you. How did I make my little book? I've made many little books like this in the past. This time, I chose to make a joke book. I wrote jokes I thought of in my little book, drew a lot of illustrations, and used some materials like these cute fluffy balls to decorate my little book. I like to write about interesting and humorous stories to make everyone happy. Although I'm not very good at drawing, I like to use the cute stickman to describe my story. Every time, I'll make my little book with my mother. After I finish writing the stories, my mother will help me outline the pictures with a marker. I like to make the little books as it allows me to express my thoughts. I learn to summarize what I've read in my little books. Thank you.
Good morning, Mrs. Lord, Mrs. Lee, Miss Mary, and teachers. My name is Asha Shaira from Tree Collaboration. Today, I'm going to share about my little book. The title of my little book is Going to the Library. This book is about the main character who enjoys going to the library. I chose to write this book because I myself like to go to the library. I've been to many libraries around Singapore. I went to the libraries with my friend. Reading improves my vocabulary and widens my knowledge and helps my writing skills. I like this little book activity because I can create my own characters and story. I make it interesting by drawing and coloring it. I also had fun exchanging written books by my friends. I read e-books during Malay lessons since primary one. After this activity, I hope that I can make an e-book. I will now end my speech with a poem. Open a book and you can be anything that you want to be. Open a book and you can share wondrous worlds you find in there. Thank you.
Good morning, Mrs. Slow, teachers, and my dear schoolmates. I'm going to share the experience about doing the small book in our Tamil class. First, many people in our class read children's storybooks written in Tamil, but some of them do not really read many storybooks. One day, our teacher told us that we had to make a small book by the story. By writing the story inside the book. First, our teacher showed us how to make the small book. And we helped each other to make the small book first. After that, we read storybooks written in Tamil. After reading them, we wrote the story into a small piece of paper and gave it to our teacher. Our teacher checked the paper that though there were no mistakes in our writings. After writing and giving it to our teacher, checked and we wrote it into our small books. After writing, we designed the book by drawing our own designs and pasting stickers and drawing pictures. After all these, our teacher also told us that we can also make many storybooks like this at home. Some of us were so excited to make the small books at home, so we made a lot of small books and handed to our teacher. Our teacher chose which one we can put up at the library. Thank you for all the teachers who put up our drawings and our inspiration in our books. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning, Mrs. Lok, Mrs. Lim, Miss Santana, and Mr. Chong, teachers and fellow students. I am Ang Jiasheng from 4K Higher Mother Tongue class. Here, I want to share my experience of making the little book with you, named Animal Architect. The book I wrote is a non-fiction book. It is about how animals build their homes and why humans should not destroy it. I searched some information from the library, rewritten the story in my own way, and presented it in a flip book. After the competition, I made it to an electronic version with the help of my mother. Throughout the process of making the e-little book, I have learned how to use the app KineMaster to create video. The best part was to add in the sound effects, as I enjoyed it very much. Before I end my sharing, just to let you know, when you receive a bookmark with a QR code on it, you can scan it and enjoy the amazing e-little books collection. A book is a door, a magic door. It can take you to places you have never been before. I hope my sharing will interest you to explore more books and give you new ideas to make little books. Thank you for your attention.
Hello， 大家好，我叫郝桂良，今年九岁，在正华小学 Tree Care 的高级华文班。今天我要跟你讲的故事是，我是从前小老师。
叮叮听到了美妙的声音，
叮叮一走进小乐的房间，就惊呆了。他张着嘴，惊讶地说：“
钢琴是你用零用钱买的吗？”
小乐说：“对呀，
妈妈每天只给我们俩两块钱，多不够买啊。”叮叮，
大家好，我是林倩妮，今天我要和大家分享我的小小书，题目是《一年四季》。一年有四季，春天、夏天、秋天和冬天。春天草儿绿，花儿开。夏天天气热，水边玩。秋天树叶黄，天变凉。
大家好，我的名字是郑仁浩，今天我要给你们介绍我的小小书。它的主题是猴子捞月。在一片茂密的树林里，住着一群猴子。这天，猴子们正在小河旁玩耍。这时，一只猴子爬到了高高的树上，它低头一看，水中有一个月亮，于是它通知了所有猴子。猿猴听他这么一喊，便都跑过来看。
This is actually our rating progress when we first have this concept during the conception stage. They say that we want to read and read and read and become a lifelong learners. So for Chinese, 99 sounds like 99 sounds like 99 for a very long time. So we encourage students to read.And read and read, not only in Zhenhua Primary School, but after Zhenhua Primary School, they continue to read and learn so that they become a lifelong learner. This is called 阅读九九. So we have an intention of every level, maybe to make 99 little books, so that after that we spread them around. So that's why you can see here we have a collection of more than 300 little books, plus many others with the teachers.So that once you read the book, you'll be touched by the contents, you'll learn from it. So it's called 感动九九. So we have this title called 阅读九九, read 99, which has the same meaning as long for very long time, 感动九九. Hence the name of this program.
校长，来，校长来。
end of the ceremony today. On behalf of Mother Tongue Department, I would like to thank everyone for joining us here today. My special thanks to Mrs. Loke, Ms. Santana, and Mr. Cheung for gracing this event today. And also my special thanks to all our reading ambassadors, all our Mother Tongue teachers, as well as all of you students, for your great effort and support to make this event possible. Thank you.